Hey guys, what's up? I'm Rohit Khurana, host on Click Digest, and today we are gonna compare the Euphoria versus Redmi 2 versus Lenovo A6000 Plus. They are in a very similar price bracket and they come with very similar specifications and features. In this video, we are gonna tell you which one you should pick and why. Let's get started. First and foremost, I'll start with the design and build of these three phones, which are very different from each other. The Euphoria from U, which is a venture of Micromax, comes with a metallic design. There is a metal frame all around and there is a plastic back which is removable. It uses premium materials and looks fairly rich. It's a large 5-inch display phone, followed by Redmi, which is made out of plastic and nice quality materials here. It comes with a 4.7-inch display, which is smaller. It does not look as rich as the Euphoria does because of the metallic rim that it gets. Next is the Lenovo A6000 Plus, which looks exactly like the A6000, which is made out of plastic. And this is also made out of good quality plastic materials and also does not have the appeal that the Euphoria has because it is made out of metal. This one is also a 5-inch phone and is same size as Euphoria, whereas the Redmi 2 is smaller with a 4.7-inch display. When it comes to front glass protection, there is Gorilla Glass 3 on the Euphoria, which is among the most superior ones that these three phones have. And the Redmi 2 also comes with Dragon Tail Glass from Asahi, which is again scratch resistant, followed by Lenovo, which uses none of these two and uses some other proprietary glass, and we do not know whether it is as effective in scratch resistance as the other two phones. Next thing I'm gonna talk about is the display quality and display temperature. As you can see, all three screens have Google Now background, which is white in color, and you will see a slight yellowish tinge here, slight bluish tinge here, and a more natural white here. So when it comes to color temperatures, Lenovo is most accurate compared to the other two, whereas the Redmi has a slightly colder temperature, whereas the Euphoria has a slightly warmer temperature. But it is not that big a problem. Let me give you a real life example by playing a video. I'm playing the same video on all three of phones, and you can compare how it looks on these three phones. In my opinion, all three displays are very good and they have good viewing angles. From steep angles, you can see the display, and they all come with very good quality panels. It's a matter of choice whether you prefer a smaller display. You can go with Redmi 2. If you prefer a larger display, which is slightly larger here at 5 inches compared to 4.7 inches, you can pick one between the Lenovo A6000 Plus or the Euphoria. Let me also give you a comparison of the music playback quality on speaker phones of all three phones. I'll put the volume to maximum and play same track on three phones one by one so that you can compare the loudness and clarity. This is the Euphoria. This one is the Redmi 2. And this one is the Lenovo A6000 Plus. All three are almost equally loud, but there is more surround on the Lenovo A6000 Plus, more deep bass on the Redmi 2, and more loudness and mid-tones on the Euphoria. So when it comes to music, all three are doing good when it comes to loudness. In terms of clarity, they are all slightly different. They all use good quality chipsets when it comes to audio. Next very important feature is the camera. And when it comes to rear camera, all three phones sport an 8 megapixel camera. But when it comes to front facing camera, Euphoria is ahead of other two phones with a 5 megapixel front facing camera, while the other two have just a 2 megapixel sensor. Let me take a picture with all three phones, the same picture with same angles, and compare the same. I am just taking these shots in automatic mode with both front and rear facing camera, and I'll show you the results for all three phones. So you can compare them for yourself, which one you find the best among these three. I'm just gonna take these pictures. HDR is off on all three phones, and I'm shooting in automatic mode for all three phones. So here are the results. You can see these are the front facing camera pictures. So let me start with the Euphoria, and it seems to be capturing a lot of details and the clarity is very high. Followed by Redmi, which seems to be using beauty mode very aggressively and giving sharp pictures, but the detailing is not as good. As you can see, the pixels are kind of very limited here. And same is the case with the Lenovo A6000 Plus, which is neither that clean nor that detailed. So if you ask me to rate these three, I would say it's number one, Euphoria, followed by the Redmi, and followed by the Lenovo A6000 Plus, which is at number three. Now let me show you the rear facing camera shots and give you a comparison. So this is the Euphoria, this is the Redmi, and here we have the Lenovo A6000 Plus. And these are the shots, as you can see here, in terms of detailing, clarity and color quality. They are fairly close, and the 8 megapixel sensors on all three cameras are working very well when it comes to taking pictures. So we don't have any major troubles taking good quality pictures with the rear facing camera. And the different in color tones that you see here of white is slightly different because of the temperature difference of the displays. This is balanced, this is slightly bluish because it's colder, and this is slightly yellowish because it's warmer. Detailing is equally good on all three when it comes to rear camera, but for front facing camera, Euphoria takes the lead with the 5 megapixel camera, which gives very sharp results. Next thing I'm gonna talk about is the performance. All three phones use the same chipset, which is the Snapdragon 410 clocked at 1.2 GHz, but there is better performance on the Euphoria because it is using a 64-bit operating system, that is Android Lollipop, while the other phones are using Android KitKat underneath, and they are running their skins, which is the Vibe UI on Lenovo A6000 Plus, Mi UI on Redmi, and there is a Cyanogen mode on Lollipop on the Euphoria. So in terms of performance, you will find that the performance of Euphoria is better compared to other two because there is a better 64-bit OS which is supported on Euphoria. Also, one major difference is RAM. The Euphoria and Lenovo A6000 Plus come with 2GB of RAM, whereas there is only 1GB RAM on Redmi 2. There is a limited edition variant which is yet to be launched, which will be launched at a higher price, which will come with 2GB RAM. But as of now, if you consider the Redmi 2 available right now, it comes with 1GB of RAM. So also, when it comes to internal memory, you get 16GB of internal memory on Lenovo A6000 Plus and Euphoria, whereas you get only 8GB of internal memory on the Redmi 2. So if you plan on carrying a lot of multimedia, you will have to install a micro SD card to the Redmi 2, which comes with the least internal memory among these three. All three phones support external micro SD cards. So if you plan on playing games and multitasking, it's better that you stick with a phone which has more RAM, which is Euphoria or Lenovo A6000 Plus. And if you consider the absolute performance, you will find that the Euphoria is best among these three because it runs 64-bit OS as well as has 2GB of RAM. Another major difference that I want to highlight here is the sensors that these phones have. If you are into gaming and you want a good quality, precise gaming experience, you would want sensors like the gyro sensor, the linear acceleration sensor, etc. In terms of sensors, the Redmi 2 and Euphoria are equally loaded, and they have a lot of sensors, which includes direction, G sensor, acceleration, light, e-compass, proximity, gyroscope. There is linear acceleration and rotation vector sensors. So there are lots of sensors which are supported here, whereas on Lenovo A6000 Plus, you only get a few sensors, which includes the acceleration sensor, light sensor and proximity sensors, and there are no other sensors which are supported on the Lenovo A6000 Plus. So if you are into gaming, you better pick either of these two phones, and if you are considering the absolute RAM performance and 64-bit OS, Euphoria seems to be the best choice for gamers. And there are two more features where the Redmi 2 stands out among these three phones, which is the USB OTG support, which only Redmi 2 supports among these three phones. And there is LED notification below the home button of the Redmi 2. Notifications, there is an LED just below the home button on the Redmi 2, while the other two phones do not have LED notifications. Next, I'm going to talk about the battery life. On the Euphoria, you get a 2230 milliamp battery. On the Redmi 2, you get a 2200 milliamp battery. And on the Lenovo A6000 Plus, you get a 2300 milliamp battery. All three phones will practically give you similar battery life, with A6000 Plus being slightly longer because it is better optimized than other two phones slightly. Also, there is quick charge technology on the Euphoria as well as Redmi 2, but there is no quick charge on the Lenovo A6000 Plus. And one more difference that I want to highlight here is that either of the SIMs on Euphoria and the Redmi 2 can be used to access data or 4G or 3G, but on the Lenovo A6000 Plus, you can access data connection only on SIM 1 and not on SIM 2. And just for clarification, you can have SIM data activated only on one of the SIMs at a time. Summing up my comparison of the Euphoria, the Redmi 2 and the A6000 Plus, I would say if you want performance, if you want a big display and good camera quality, you can easily go with Euphoria, which is among the best in terms of design as well as value for money as well. The Euphoria is at 7000 rupees. The Redmi 2 is also at 7000 rupees, whereas the Lenovo A6000 Plus is at 7500 rupees. Besides being the most expensive among these three, this one comes with least number of sensors when it comes to gaming. However, when it comes to RAM, the A6000 Plus and Euphoria are similar at 2GB RAM. But only one of these phones, which is the Euphoria, supports 64-bit OS Lollipop, which gives better performance compared to the other two phones and also scores higher on the benchmark scores. All three phones are very sorted when it comes to display, but if you are looking at overall value for money, the Euphoria stands out and comes out to be number one, closely followed by the Lenovo A6000 Plus and Redmi 2 in their respective fields. Few downsides of Euphoria are that it does not have LED notification and OTG support, but it is better in almost every other aspect. This is all we have on this comparison. We hope you enjoyed watching it and this comparison helped you. If it did help you, don't forget to give us a thumbs up by pressing the like button below. We have done many more videos on all three phones separately, so make sure you check out the links in the description section below for the playlist where we have these videos. For latest video updates from Intellect Digest, make sure to hit the red subscribe button. This is all we have on this one. I hope to see you in my next video. This is your host Rohit Khurana signing off. Thanks for watching.